AI SSMS Institute of Information Technology, and today we are going to cover the topic of actually electronic system design. In this, we want to cover the part of DBMS and SQL, this concept, introduction and concept. So the points which today I am going to cover, that is need an overview, then hierarchy, then classification, creating a database table, basics of normalization, data integrity, current trends, introduction to non-SQL databases, basics of SQL, then insert, update, delete operations, retrieve database on query, sorting and filtering data, advanced filtering, summarizing data, grouping data, using subqueries, nested queries, joining tables, managing tables, using views, and generating reports. These are the points which we are going to cover under this, that is DBMS and SQL and DBMS, these points. Okay, so let us start from DBMS. So coming to our point, that is DBMS. So database management system. Here, what exactly it is? The long form of this DBMS is database management system, a software system that allows user to define, create and maintain a database and provides controlled access to the data. I think many of you have are having idea that many of the people are working on database management system. In some of the universities or some of the curriculum, you may have observed that there is one separate course which is totally based on database management system, DBMS. Okay, people are working on that because nowadays there are so many problems were there regarding storage of data and how to manage the data, that things were there. So different clouds and all these concepts come in picture. And now the system, it is 100% based on the database management system because this data is very, very important. I think in all applications, you can have these things. So take an example of suppose weather monitoring system. There also we required 100% data from day one to day, means throughout the year, I will say. And then we can have comparison of the data for the next year, like this. Similarly, the same things are there. Suppose you can take the second example, that is university. You'll find that there are the data, and that data is related to, it may be related to syllabus. What was the syllabus in earlier year? What was the syllabus in last 5 years? What will be there in the coming 5 years? So these things are there. So data management system is one of the very, very important thing as far as the application is concerned. And electronic system design, it is again in this for electronic system design, we require this type of points for designing point of view for any system. Suppose we want to design a system based on this, then we must have the idea about data management system. So what exactly it is? DBMS stands for database management system. Okay, database management system, software system that allows user to define, create and maintain a database and provides controlled access to the data. Controlled access, how to define, how to create, how to maintain the database, and very important, that is how to control it also. Then what is one more thing which is mentioned, that is RDBMS. What is RDBMS? That is relational database management system. Just now I had a discussion with you that is related to weather monitoring systems. Suppose this is the month of, suppose October now, correct? What was the condition in last October, that is October 2019? So there is some relation in between this October month and the last year October month. So we may have relation of this thing, that is database, data management. So we may relate this type of examples and this type of things we may have in our electronic system design. So that is relational database management system based on relational data model. Then all information is represented as a relations, and relations are viewed as two-dimensional tables. I think in design there is one more concept which is called as mathematical model. You may have heard this name, I don't know, but this is there as far as design is concerned. Suppose you want to write a paper, article, correct, in a publication. At that time, what people are doing, they are designing their work, okay? And while designing that, at the end, after the derivation or calculation, there is one relation in between output and input, like this. So there they are developing one model, which is called as mathematical model, okay? Similarly here, and that is, there is some relation in between input and output. So here what I am telling to you, that is really all information is represented as a relations, and relations are viewed as two-dimensional tables. Okay. Now, this is the overview of DBMS, complete computer system. What exactly here? Hardware. In computer, you may have observed that there is one part which is called as hardware. Second is software. Third important system part, it is data. And today we are discussing the same. And then one more is procedures. And lastly, how to use users, correct? So these things, components are there as far as complete computer system it is concerned. That is database management system. We have to think about this also. That is hardware, software, data, procedure, user, like this. Next is, what are the advantages of DBMS? One is systematic way of organizing the data. DBMS is systematic way of organizing the data. Database management system, systematic way of organizing the data. Then second is maintaining data integrity. Third is ease of updating the data. Fourth one, faster way querying and retrieving the data. Then one more is extracting meaningful information from the data. Means you can have the summary, meaningful data. Then easy distribution of information, securing the data, maintenance of the data and the system, and easy disaster recovery. Recovery of the data is also equally important. I think you may have seen in market that many of the peoples, they are retrieving the data, recovering the data from our hard disk. Sometimes there is some problem in computer or laptop or somewhere else. At that time, again, recovery of the data, that is also very, very important. So all these things are there as far as the advantages of database management system it is concerned. Okay, what are that? Again, in brief, one very important, it is systematic way of arranging the data. Second is maintaining the data integrity, updating the data, faster way of querying the retrieving the data, meaningful information from the data, distribution of information, securing the data, maintenance of the data, and recovery of the data. These are the important points as far as database management it is concerned, advantages. Then keys of the relation. So candidate key, primary key, foreign key, this concept is there. Okay. So that we will see as far as relation it is concerned. Relation means in between the data, that we will see. Let us wait for 1 minute. Okay. So